Very cool. I think in the end she won't want me to have her, so she'll listen.
That would be most reasonable. It's a tough time in the year to be ill.
My brother's wife's also a doctor, and we're just not inundating her with internet information. She'll start printing out the information. My mother's not that calm.
Larry, take it out.
They told my mother to stop meditating.
That'll be good.
Get in touch with her inside.
I'm not used to it.
Space on a seat with purses, coats, etc. If you could just put those aside so we can have as much room as possible for people who want to be here.
My name is Eileen Duff. I'm the presiding counselor today over the hearing with Jean Curran. We are not having our typical noontime meeting with the governor today. So we're going to start this meeting a little bit differently. I'm going to ask you all to stand and pledge the flag, and then we're going to have a moment of silence for the fallen firefighter whose option goes. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Just a moment of silence for the fallen firefighter in Watertown. His family. There are other councilors who will be arriving. We have a little bit of snow happening right now, and we have councilors coming from far away, and we also have some traffic happening, which was unexpected, but it's Boston, so here we go. So don't worry if people come in during it. To start the hearing, I will read the nomination letter from the governor, dated February 21st. Dear councilors, I am pleased to nominate Jean M. Curran to the position of Associate Justice of the Haverhill District Court, Essex County Division. I submit this nomination for advice and consent of the Executive Council, pursuant to Part 2, Chapter 2 of the Constitution of the Commonwealth of Massachusetts. I'm enclosing the nominee's resume for your convenience. Sincerely, Charles. So we will start the hearing with the folks who've come to testify on behalf of Jean Curran. And first on the witness list is Jonathan Blodgett, District Attorney for the Eastern District. Dave Blodgett, you can either stand or sit right next to the nominee and give us
information on the chair. Is anyone speaking in opposition?
Is there anyone speaking in opposition?
Based on that, I make a motion that we have the hearing remain open for rebuttal.
Okay.
I'll second that.
All right.
Good morning, Council. My name is Jonathan Blodgett. I'm the District Attorney for the Eastern District, commonly known as Essex County. It's my pleasure to be before you this morning. We have Jean Marie Curran, who is the most worthy applicant. I've known Jean for over 25 years, close to 30 years actually, both when I was a defense attorney for 16 years in the CDP, and in the last 14 years as district attorney. And I'll tell you, during that time, I've had many ample opportunities to interact with judges, defense prosecutors, and there is nobody, I suggest you respectfully, who has a better judicial comportment or makeup than Jean Curran. Jean has proven herself to be somebody who not only is a worthy advocate with respect to the adversarial process, but to someone who does that without being adversarial. Anyone, judges, lawyers, clerks, people in the court system, she's always respectful to them. She's had occasion to deal with them. I've been in her presence in court situations where things have gotten very much out of control, and one person always kept her control in the best fashion. Trials can become emotional, trials can become somewhat combative, but Jean never loses her cool, not once. I will tell you that I think that I think of another person that I interact with, either as a defense attorney or district attorney, who's more willing to listen to people, listen to the points of view than Jean. Her history is proven in that regard. I would tell you that you'll hear Noah, I suggest you dealt with her. Interact with her in any fashion or any kind of role in terms of either being a victim or a defense attorney or a witness who thinks that she was fair, was honest, was convenient. And to that, I don't want to be redundant, but I wholeheartedly support the candidacy. I will miss her if she's successful as a judge and full officer. She's held in such high regard. Many people who are out here today to show the support as well as members of law enforcement.
Before I ask the councilors if they have any questions, if you want, I will introduce them. This is Councilor Mary Hurley from the Springfield area, Councilor Joe Fierro from the Cape, and Councilor Bob Jupiter from Milton.
Madam Chair, I just want
Madam Chair, and the benefit of Councilor Dupinville, there will be opposition. I've made a motion that I would request that the hearing stay open for rebuttal. All right.
In the Honorable Mary Kay Ames, Justice of the Superior Court. Judge Ames, can you tell us what the city was, what it is that you said?
Well, I'm Suffolk Superior Court.
Suffolk.
So I'm for general jurisdiction for the entire state, although I sit most frequently in Suffolk County, but I summer in Lawrence. It's a great pleasure to be back before this body. It's amazing to me that it's been 5 years since I appeared before this august body and as a nominee of the Superior Court. It's a pleasure to be with you here this morning to speak in favor of this excellent nominee. As a Superior Court judge, as I say, I sit each summer, I request to sit each summer in Lawrence Superior Court. It's delightful. And that's where I got to know the nominee, Jean Curran. She's appeared before me many, many times during the last 5 years. Although I must say, I've known members of her family going back literally decades. Her dad, Lieutenant Jim Curran from the Boston Police Department, was the head of the unit, the investigatory unit, the Suffolk County District Attorney's Office, when I was in charge of the homicide division there. And I knew her uncle, Lieutenant Detective John Curran, who goes back many, many years, affectionately known as Pinky. Jean obviously comes from a strong tradition, a family tradition of public service and seeking of justice. She's tried many cases before me, including many very challenging cases and multiple homicides cases. And here's what I've seen. I just want to make it clear to the point. She has a dedication to justice. She's hardworking. She doesn't seek for the easy answer. She doesn't seek to win or to gain advantage. She seeks justice. She tries in every case that I have seen her participate in to find justice and to do justice. She's incredibly hardworking. It is not unusual for me to leave very late from the courthouse, and who am I usually walking out the door with, but Assistant District Attorney. She is sympathetic and understands the needs of victims and victims' families. She is compassionate to victims and victims' families. And I've seen her interact with victims' families under the most difficult of circumstances, giving them solace and comfort. She always does what is right. She does what's right in a case, not necessarily what might be advantageous in a case. And I've watched repeatedly as she's come to sidebar to explain something to me that may not have been in the best position for her case. But again, she seeks to do justice. She is held in very high regard by the defense bar because above all else, she is fair. She is fair. She understands her obligations as a member of the bar and as an assistant district attorney. There is never a single solitary concern in my courtroom when Jean is trying the case before me. And I've never heard any concern by any member of the defense bar. In fact, 201, the defense bar is praised of Jean Curran and the fairness that she exhibits in her position. And finally, demeanor. She's calm, almost serene, in the light of what can be a very chaotic day. Always respectful, even if she's faced with disrespect, as can happen as we all know in the courtroom. She's always respectful. And that's with everyone. She treats everyone with kindness, respect, and dignity. And I think she possesses exactly the qualities that we hope to have in any judge, particularly in the busy district court. The only thing I'm sad about is that she won't be joining us in the Superior Court. But the district court, where 95% of the work and the justice takes place, I think would be a much better place for having Jean Curran as Associate Justice. And I strongly urge you to vote in favor of her nomination. And thank you so much. I said this is always such a good day when we're here to talk about good candidates and to see the process in action. I'm so happy to be able to be a part of it. Thank you, Councilor.
Thank you. As an attorney, but someone who spent 30 years in law enforcement, 9 years as chief of police and service, in past life and in present.
Thank you so much.
Thank you,
Thank you, Councilor.
You've been both a prosecutor for a long time.
16 years of each.
One of the concerns we have with prosecutors would they be able to transition to prosecution?
I have no doubt, because as we all know, what makes a good prosecutor isn't something that means a cost, rather someone who does justice. And that means, in many instances, protecting the rights of those who get prosecuted. And I've seen Gene do that. I've seen her rise to that each and every time. So that, although she hasn't practiced as a defense counsel, I think I see demonstrate a keen awareness of the rights of others and the awesome responsibility that you have when you do that. Willie Davis told me a long time ago, dean of the defense bar, if you're a prosecutor, you need to be able to wear the red jersey or the blue jersey at any time. If you do need to draw correctly, then you understand what both of those obligations are. It's really they're both embodied in the role of prosecutor. She does that. As I say, calm in the face of the storm, always respectful on what else is happening in the courtroom. I have never seen her, even under very difficult circumstances, where maybe someone has been less than respectful to her, she does not respond. She always responds to each person with kindness, treats everyone with dignity, and with respect. And most importantly, I think, too, never throws in the heart, and you can be in the midst of a heated argument, you can have a difficult cross-examination, and I can still see the calmness takes over, and she's able to think very clearly and still keep right on proper path. Treats everyone with dignity and respect. I have no concerns about her demeanor. I think she has. Now, not once, not even with me. I've never seen it, never once. I see her take a deep breath from time to time. That's okay.
Thank you very much.
My great pleasure.
Thanks a lot.
Thank you. Always a pleasure.
Madam Chair.
Yes.
Just an observation. As a retired district court judge of almost 20 years, I'm going to have your testimony for this hearing memorialized, because you said the district court does 95% of the work.
True.
And I've been saying that for a long time before I retired. So I appreciate that. I appreciate your testimony. Thank you.
That's a really thank you. Judge, thank you so very much.
You call me anything but late for dinner.
We never sure whether to call our judge or counselor, but thank you, Judge.
Thank you, counselor. I appreciate it.
The next witness on the list is Alexandria Pina, administrative assistant. You out of Salem?
Yes. Good morning. My name is Alexandria Pena, and I am an administrative assistant at the Essex District Attorney's Office. I have been employed at the District Attorney's Office for 9 years, and I have had the pleasure of working with Gene Curran for about 5 years. As a colleague and as a friend, I can say that Gene is very caring, kind, and thoughtful person. And I can tell from personal experience that everyone in the office feels the same way. She treats everyone from the receptionist, support staff, and other attorneys with dignity and respect. Jean has always been very professional and respectful in court. But the one thing that has stood out to me the most is that she is always calm and even tempered. It reminds me of one day when I went to watch her on the murder trial, which I don't get to do often. The case was regarding a stabbing. As I watched, I could feel the tension in the courtroom. It didn't help matters that the defense counsel on this case was on edge and very aggressive. He tried his best for a Keen. But as always, Keen was very composed, even killed, and handled herself very professionally, which didn't surprise me at all. It's who she is as a person. With that being said, I truly truly believe in my heart that you will be the same as a judge and will be a credit to the bench. The opportunity to speak on behalf of you.
Thank you. Questions? Any questions?
Very good.
Thank you. The next witness on the list is Lawrence McGuire, Law Office.
Members of the council, good morning. I say it is a pleasure to be here to speak on behalf of Jean Curran, a woman, a prosecutor that I've known now for the last 24 years. I've been practicing criminal defense in Essex County for 40 years. I started in 1976 and was a member of the Committee for Public Counsel Services. Before that, the Massachusetts Defenders Committee, I retired in 2010. Since then, I'm still in practice of law. I've seen Jean Curran, and I knew Jean Curran when she was a new prosecutor in the Lynn District Court. We've been through misdemeanors and murders together the last 25 years. And I can't say that I have found a better prosecutor, a nicer prosecutor, a more diligent prosecutor. Councilman Jubenville and Judge Ames brought to mind the standard, the APA standard for prosecutors. The duty of the prosecutor, says the APA, is to seek justice, not merely conviction. And if there's one person who has a prosecutor who has sought justice, and not simply convictions, it's Jean Curran. Judge Ames brought to mind a very important thing. Reminded me that when in trial, Jean is always looking out for justice. And in times when a defense lawyer may have fumbled and not brought up an issue that should be brought up, Jean Curran has done it. Jean Curran puts justice before all else. I know that I can speak for that, the entire Essex County defense lawyer. She's a great prosecutor. She's knowledgeable. She's prepared. She comes to court always ready, and she has excellent trial skills. But more than that, Jean Curran is ethical. You can trust her with anything. Her word is her bond. And those of us who have done criminal defense work in various counties know that that is not always the truth. But when Jean Curran speaks, you can take that to the bank. She's respectful. She's respectful of the court, probably because of her background. She's respectful of the judges. She's respectful of the prosecution function. Ladies and gentlemen, members of the council, she is respectful of people. And those people include the defendants. She's never demonized the defendant. She sees the defendant as a human being, albeit a human being who may have stumbled, whom she has to prosecute. You can go to Jean Curran. You can tell Jean about a client's background, and what the client has done and suffered in his life. And Jean will hear you. But more than that, she will listen. She will take that into account when she decides what the recommendation must be. Now, she'll think about it, consider it, talk to you. She may not come out with the recommendation you want, but you have the satisfaction. Jean has not just brushed you off. Jean has given you her time and attention. Let me just give you one example. I had 20 years ago a young man who committed a series of breaking and entries in North Shore Times. It was all over the newspaper. They wanted to corrupt. Finally, they caught him. He was an unfortunate drug addict. He had a great deal of problems in his life. The newspapers really wanted him in prison for the rest of his life. Jean had the case. Lucky day for him. I went to Jean, I compiled what I knew about the man, his background, that information. Jean took it all, she thought about it, she read it, she discussed it with me, and we came to a reasonable resolution. Another prosecutor might have just said, sorry, lad, the newspapers are all over this. I'm not going to be bothered. You do what you have to. Jean would follow up. Occasionally said, how is he doing? How is Ken doing? Now tell me, this is how Ken did. The recommendation was some time in prison, then probation. While in prison, Ken learned how to be a mason. He is now in charge of his own masonry company in Salem, New Hampshire. He has Gene Curran to thank. I occasionally see him, and he tells me that he has Gene Curran to thank for that. Put his prior life aside, he made up very well. He has Gene to thank for that. The defense bar in Essex County certainly appreciates. Yesterday, I had a occasion, now that I'm an old man, I do a lot of mentoring for bar advocates, those of the lawyers, private lawyers, who take cases by appointment. And I happened to have in my office a young man who was having his one of his first district court trials. We were going over it yesterday. And the case was going to be on today, and he said, "You think you could come over to court today and, you know, kind of be there?" I said, "Well, no, I have to go in and appear before the governor's council on behalf of the prosecutors seeking to become a judge." I said, "Who's that?" I said, "Her name is Jean Curran." This fellow does district court cases exclusively. He said, "Oh, Jean Curran, I know her. I had a case, my client also had a case. And so Gene came to the district court in order to coordinate efforts. You know, I didn't know what to expect. I really was in awe because this was a district court, district attorney. But you know something? She didn't look down on me. She treated me like a human being. She treated me like I was her equal. She's an awfully good person. She's really, a really very good person. You know something? Gene Curran is a really why Gene Curran is a really excellent prosecutor. I would suggest to you, ladies and gentlemen, that a really good person, Gene Curran, will make a really great district court judge. And I ask you to approve your nomination as a district court judge.
Thank you. Question?
Thank you. Good to see you.
Absolutely not. Not with Gene. Gene is a professional person. Gene is a real human being. She doesn't take pleasure in seeing people out of prison. She knows what has to be done. She does it very well. But she, as I said, I try to emphasize this to you. She sees people as human beings. She sees them as flawed human beings. She sees them as human beings. I want to say this while I have the opportunity. I don't see anybody in front of life. He runs a really professional office.
Thank you. I know you
I couldn't be happier. I couldn't have been happier. I would just, in fact, that fellow who I was talking to about the fire advocate yesterday said, "Oh, I wish you was appointed now. I'd love to have my fire." I got to the Haverhill District Court and I knew Gene was sitting there. I'd make sure I got a reception. I'd use all those wiles we learned to get my case.
I thank you very much for taking time. Use the same hair color.
So sometimes we have nominees and we ask them about form shopping and judge shopping. Some of them say, "Yes, I do it, you have to do it." And others say, "No, it's wrong, I take what I get." Probably, you're good at judge shopping.
Well, I don't know about you. You have to ask my client.
If I ever get in trouble in Essex, I'm calling you out of the time.
Okay.
Thank you.
Bring him in.
One question. Turn the wires.
One question.
Sorry. Between yourself and the fellow who uses the same hair dye, who's older?
I don't look at those.
to take this opportunity before we continue to introduce Councilman Jen Casey. Is there anyone else here this morning who would like to testify in favor of Attorney Curran?
I would not.
Come before us, state your name and where you're from.
Sure. John Morris, Sykes, Mass. I'm a pro defense attorney in Essex County. Morning, Madam Chairman, and ladies and gentlemen of the council. I'm here today to enthusiastically support the nomination of Gene Curran as the Justice of the District Court of the Commonwealth. I've known Gene for many years. She is a prosecutor and me as a defense attorney. I've always found Gene to be a dedicated student of the law with a perfect temperament to deal with any issue that arises. These qualities, as well as many others, give Gene the ability to be an excellent judge. As a defense attorney that appears in many courts in the Commonwealth before many judges, I look for a judge who is consistent and knowledgeable about the law. Gene is both. I hope that you confirm Gene's nomination with the same confidence I have in her abilities and dedication. Thank you for allowing me to address you today on Gene's behalf.
Thank you, Attorney.
Counsel,
any questions? And I'll take this opportunity before we continue. Councilor Terry Kennedy.
My apologies for being late. I hit a lot of traffic.
Anyone else to testify on behalf or in favor, sir?
Very briefly.
State your name and where you're from.
Hi, Judge Robert Cordell, Mr. Court, from Foster, Massachusetts. I just come here. Larry McGuire here in front of his
It has been 20 months since our son's passing. Every morning we wake up thinking about him, thinking about what we've lost. Every night we go to sleep thinking about him. The loss at times is unbearable. The untimely loss of a child is something I do not wish on anyone. For the longest time we were in a fog. did, however, get brief counseling, and the fog has partially lifted. I especially began to investigate the specific why in my son's case. I have read reports, investigated, and corresponded with nationally known experts in criminal justice, disability law, and nationally known reporters. I studied the neurobiology of the teen brain. In short, I have become a passionate advocate for change because I do not want this to happen to anyone else. I also want you to understand how this is for us. We are private people, and I know this testimony may bring unwanted attention. It is, however, important that this statement is heavy, so is my briefcase that contains everything that can back up what I said today and what I previously disclosed to you. I'm happy to share any information that I have. I realize that there are many bad decisions to make, including my son's. He did something that he should not have done. He made a mistake. He was 18 years old. I do not need to rehash the specific elements of his case, but he did have a lot of elements to his case that made it unique. By now, you've read the information. However, I do need to highlight the role of over-prosecution and lack of caring that Assistant DA Gene Curran had in my son's case, and in particular also the Essex County DA's, to which he is solidly part of. First, I must briefly mention the Essex County DA's office. It is important since Assistant DA Curran is the senior prosecutor in the office and has been prosecuted for over 20 years. In my research, I learned that the incarceration rates from this office the group. Criminal cases entered in the Superior Court Division are far above what they should be for the socioeconomics of the region. For example, in the year 2016, Essex County had 562 criminal entries compared to 607 in Middlesex County, which has a population three times that of Essex County. These were all Massachusetts health scams. We all know that cases taken to the Superior Court are deemed more serious. And those defendants face the prospect of longer sentences and state prison. Speaking to defense attorneys, I learned that the reputation of Essex County DA's office is one that persecutes and prosecutes. That's my words. So many people within the court system have spoken to wonder why some of the cases that are prosecuted are handled in the way that they are in terms of the level of prosecution and sentence design. The local newspapers published letters to the editor from concerned citizens asking the same thing when they read reports of sentences handed down, whether through a plea deal or court determination. I do know that a judge does make a final determination, but they often take into account the wishes of the prosecution. When I learned of the nomination of Gene Curran for associate judge, I nearly fell off my chair, literally. Prosecutor Curran has been a prosecutor for 20 years, and sadly embodies the culture of the Essex County DA's office. He is a great prosecutor, which in Essex County means ruthless and tough. As a senior staff member, she generally gets high-profile cases, and I have no problem with serious criminals receiving the tough sentence that they deserve. I've gone back over the years of her career as best I can to previous newspaper accounts. Cases, and I find a pattern in the office. Just as an aside, the case that the defense attorney was speaking about, the same one that I'm thinking of, was breaking and entering case that was in the news quite a bit. And Counselor Curran was asking for 5 years in state prison for a housebreak. That's the same case. Many indictments, lots of convictions, and pleadings, and a regular pattern of requesting severe sentences seen excessive for the crime. I am not sure that she realized the effect that prison can have on the trajectory of one's life. It's likely that she rose to the top because she was good at her quote-unquote job. I can discuss specific past and recent cases within the office and those specific to Gene Curran. As a senior prosecutor, you have great discretion on how to proceed on specific assigned cases. You can make the decision that some cases should not be prosecuted at all or have alternative justices offered. Within 5 minutes of taking my son's case and talking with the defense attorney, before learning any of the specific circumstances of my son's case that were disclosed later to her, prior to that, she told the defense that she wanted jail time. Within 5 minutes, an 18-year-old with no prior criminal history, a history of depression, and severe medically verified social skill issues and immaturity based on a medical condition, jail time. In my opinion, jail should not be first line for a nonviolent, first-time young offender who ends up in front of a prosecutor or a judge, especially the young, quote-unquote, adult in the days of social media where the stakes never go away. The trajectory of my son's life would have been negatively affected had he lived. Does she know that with an eye towards compassion and by treating the case for what it really was, a mistake by an immature kid with a verified medical social condition, that she could have had a positive impact instead? I wonder how many others over the years could have been given a boost instead. A judge has a role to punish those who deserve punishment, but they are also in a position to rehabilitate and to give a boost up to those in need. In a sense, because of the discretion afforded to prosecutors, we see what she has done in the past when faced with making life-altering decisions. It's important to understand that a district judge is often the one making these life-altering decisions in terms of guilt versus innocence, rehabilitation versus incarceration, compassion versus indifference. The jury trial is infrequent, the bench trial very common. I think it's fair and accurate based on the entirety of her career that we know where she stands. Prosecutor Curran has a long track record as a fierce prosecutor. A leopard cannot change her spots. There is momentum in the State House this session to enact reforms on the judicial system. One idea already drafted into more than one bill allows greater access to conversion prior to arraignment for a greater range of offenses, both misdemeanor and felony, with the decision to allow diversion being placed in the hands of a judge and probation officer. The DA would not have a role. Well, I think the proposal is sound and it hopefully passes. It does depend on a judge who understands that felony convictions and incarceration should not be a first resort in all cases. I fear that very few people facing her would be offered diversion in her court based on her past history of decisions, including my son's case. Again, realize what felony convictions and jail time do to cost to society, to the state. Jean Curran may be a nice person. When you meet her in person, certainly calm in her demeanor. But just like an athlete, when she goes to work, she's competitive and unwavering in her view of what justice is. Felony convictions and periods of incarceration. And again, I mentioned the case that we spoke about earlier. Some jail time, but you have the same case, 5 years. A couple of other things to consider in a nominee besides judgment and beliefs about justice are compassion and leadership. As far as leadership goes, I think that possibly she could have been a mentor to others in her office after what happened to my son. People possibly could have listened. Sadly, I have read about another case recently that reminds me a lot of my son's case, and it points out the need. I can discuss this in private, which I don't think it's right to speak publicly about this particular case. When thinking about compassion in our judges, understand that she has never once offered condolence to us, never once a quote-unquote sorry for your loss. I sent her the same article you received, but also with additional separate pair of letters, one from me, one from my wife. I explained that even though it would be tough, we'd like to meet with her in our home to give her a sense of who Brendan was. I explained that it would be helpful to us in our grief. She still has not responded. I say it again. I hope that she contacts us. She may learn something that would be helpful in her career and may be helpful in our grief. Finally, my motivations are clear, and that is to help others. I know that you take your job seriously. I ask that you act thoughtfully and collaboratively as some members of this council. They have more information than others, particularly counselors with an Essex comment. I am willing to discuss this further and offer all data and evidence that I have to use. They called me in last week's comment, attorney Mary Platt. Contrast her to Jean Curran, a tough career prosecutor. There are so many better choices than a prosecutor Jean Curran. I ask you